Hello, I'm Mr. Ad-Granth, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is continuation of Christianity, and Nanak was the second coming of Jesus. And here I'm rendering exposition of Matthew 5, verse 33-37. Holy Gospel of our Supernatural Father, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc., delivered by the first anointed Christ, which in Punjabi we call SATGUR, Jesus, according to St. Matthew 5, verse 33-37. Jesus said to his twice-born, laboring, solitary brethren, stroke friends, called Talmidim, or Sikhs. Talmidim mean learners, you know, or Sikhs. Sikhs stand for the same thing as learning, and not the once-born natural disciples of the crook rabbis. The root of the word disciple is discipline, and the rabbi disciplined the natural boys between 12 to 16 years old by teaching them the scripture and the moral laws. So the Messianic Jews, they introduce such corruptions in this New Testament. There is no disciple in Jesus because the once born cannot understand gospel. The twice born laborers. So the rabbis who disciplined them through the moral laws of Moses, these rabbinic disciples did what their rabbis told them to do. Thus, Saul, being the disciple of Rabbi Gamaliel, did obey him obediently as required of him, and persecuted the laborers of Jesus, but in his own heart or subconscious, he was not happy for the disciples doing what their rabbis tell them to do. They are called spiritually blind, with no freedom or free will. Thus, the substitutes, disciple and Lord, in the New Testament are the corruptions by the Messianic Jews to set up the same temple system from the yoke of which Jesus set us free by giving his own life as the Lamb of God. Are these robed, hireling, dog-colored priests in churches of Mammon have nothing to do with God, but they fulfill Matthew 12, verse 43-5, making the situation worse than before the arrival of Jesus, the first anointed Christ of our supernatural Father, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc. Now Jesus says, you have heard that it was said in your ancestors, do not take a false oath, but make good to the Lord Yahweh, who planted them into the promised land. The one who planted them in the promised land is Yahweh. Yahweh gave you food to eat. If you are faithful to him, he will give you plenty to eat. But if you are not faithful to him, then you go hungry. And this is illustrated here in a Brazilian jungle. You see the natives living there. They don't use mammon. They don't know mammon. And they have plenty to eat. They never go hungry. And they are faithful to Yahweh because they have tribal mark on their faces. By tribal mark, they remember their ancestors. From ancestor, they built their covenant to Adam, and Adam was created by Yahweh. He is Yahweh, the Lord of nature, what you see with two naked eyes. The soul inside me is of our supernatural Father, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, which you cannot see, but perceive. That's why Thomas, St. Thomas said, you know, first know what you see with your two naked eye. Then what is not seen would be known to you. So do not take a false oath, but make good to the Lord Yahweh, who planted them into the promised land, which is Garden of Eden. And Abraham equal to Adam, and Sarah equal to Eve, living in the company of Lord of creation, Yahweh. We call it Brahma, and in Arabic they call it Khuda, that they are the Lord of the nature. All that you vow, but I say to you, do not swear at all, as Abraham, being solitary, did not swear by anyone else but himself, and so you are solitary with our supernatural Father, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc., living in his temple, our physical body. Remember that Abraham, being taken from the Iraq area to settle in this promised land, so he was the head of this promised land. So he had no ancestors to swear, because he left everything, all ancestors behind, to set up a new colony of Adam and Eve in this promised land as a demonstration nation for the world to learn the moral laws from them. That's why they are called nation of priests. So Abraham was solitary. He had no linkage to his ancestors. So he would not swear by anybody else than by himself. Same way we, now Jesus is comparing us with this Abraham, because we also are solitary in our supernatural Father. Otherwise you can't enter the narrow gate leading to the vineyard of our Father. So this narrow gate, here John the Baptist baptized Jewish men in water in the name of Abraham, making them sons of Abraham. And those who have sensible enough to know their natural Father, they are seeking supernatural Father, and they are seeking this narrow gate which has the oven of his word. Remember Moses having the burning bush? This is the burning bush here. So they have to go through it to get themselves grafted in the true vine, which is Christ Jesus and Satguru Nanak. They are here. So you need to be solitary. So when you are solitary like Abraham, you cannot swear by anyone, but by yourself own. Your own testimony stands, because this is the temple of God. God lives inside you, and God knows everything. So you cannot swear by anyone. Whatever you say should be gospel truth. With our Father Elohim Allah Pabra, living in his temple, our physical body, not by heaven. Not by heaven, for it is God's throne, heaven. This is the kingdom of heaven, you see, in law and order. The royal kingdom of God is inside here, in our heart. So here it is, where I have described the two kingdoms. This is rabbinic which is the law and order. They have kingdom of heaven, and this is the royal kingdom of God within our own heart. Christianity is of heart and not of the scriptures, dead letters. So that's why Jesus said, don't take any money in your pocket, no shoe, two shoes, no two tunic, and no scripture. Bible is forbidden. And those who take Bible, they just vomit out dead letters. And they are super blind, leading the blind into the pit. They cannot explain what is written in the Bible. But they keep on reading the cross reference here and there, making you fed up. So, here we go. Our physical body, not by heaven, for it is God's throne. God's throne means that those heaven belongs to the sons of man. If you are tribal son of the tribal father, then you are son of man. And then you are the throne over which our Father God sits. Nor by the earth, for it is his footstool, nor by Jerusalem, for it is the city of the great King David of the Judah tribe. Now this seems to be added by the Messianic Jews. Messianic Jews have made corruptions in the New Testament, and Jesus had nothing to do with this secular kingdom or anything like this. So it was John the Baptist who dealt with secular affairs and the moral laws. John the Baptist was an ideal rabbi. Do not swear by your head, for you cannot make a single hair white or black. Let your yes mean yes, and your no mean no. That is correct, you know, that you should not waver. If you don't understand, tell the man, I don't understand it or something. But if you understand it and you waver, then like this, you know, I gave you example over here. Anything more is from the evil one. For example, Church of England is headed by Queen, the head of Mormon in Great Britain. And when her soldiers die during wars, her hireling dog-collared priests declare that they glorified God. Whereas Salvation Army, which they hate, say that their soldiers died for king and country. That is correct, you know. But the Church of England people, they hate Salvation Army people. If you go to St. Paul's Cathedral, there are statues of Viceroy of India, Viceroy of South Africa, and generals and all that. They say they glorify God. Our William Booth is not to be found in that St. Paul's Cathedral. He's out, and sons of Satan are in. So Church of England is of devil, while Salvation Army of God for speaking the truth, thus swearing on the Bible, the dead scripture, is blasphemer. You know, in the courts they say, put your hand on the Bible and swear. You should not swear by the Bible, you know, you should swear by the law book of the country. They should keep a law book that by this I obey the law and I swear and all that, you know. So you can see how stupid the people are. And you need to be twice born, sensible person. So our Father God blesses you.